before we get started, let's talk a little bit about the WWF Tag Team title situation. As you know, the Quebecers are the new Tag Team Champions. Since upsetting the Steiner Brothers, they said that they would defend the titles on Monday Night Raw against a worthy Team Brain. Well, they defended them Monday night all right against, in my opinion, not a worthy team, and almost lost the belts.
Not a worthy team?
Right.
The 1-2-3 Kid and his partner, they were a very good team. I mean, like you just said, they almost lost the titles.
They sure did.
Well, to the Quebecers, they were a worthy team. They're the champions. They'll make that decision.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, I got to think that the next time the Quebecers with American rules take on the Steiner Brothers are going to be the new WWF Tag Team Champions. What do you call it?
Hello? I want this building emptied. I want all these people
shut up. Let's get started.
I want everyone thrown out.
The building clear.
Well, I'm tired of these humanoids calling me weasel and everything like that. They're just jealous of me. They're easy. They shouldn't be here.
Mr. Perfect,
a two-time Intercontinental Champion, will indeed, ladies and gentlemen, be involved in the big 20-man battle royal this Monday night on Raw. I'm sure you know about that, but in case you don't, you'll hear more about it with Lord Alfred Hayes and the special report coming up just a little bit later in the broadcast. A new Intercontinental Champion will be crowned, and that process will begin this Monday night on Raw with a big 20-man over-the-top rope battle royal.
What a way to kick off the fall season, huh, Rock?
It's going to be tremendous there, Brain. And not only is Mr. Perfect in that battle royal, we also understand so is one of his biggest rivals, that's Diesel.
Well, Perfect won't be in the battle royal then. Because yes. As soon as that bell rings, you know what's going to happen. Diesel's going to go over and lay that big ham, that big right hand he has, right in the mush of Mr. Perfect and over the top row. Section 18, row 36, that's where Perfect's going to land.
Well, that remains to be seen. We'll find out this Monday night on Raw. Brian Costello, the Fighting Irishman, challenging Mr. Perfect here this week.
Who coaches him, Lou Holtz?
I don't know. I think Holtz has got a little problems right now. Oh, nice move there by Costello. Good hip lock taking Perfect up and over. And I think Perfect says, yeah, that's the way it's going to be. Then I can deal with that. This great second-generation star is certainly a phenomenal athlete, an all-round athlete. Collar and elbow tie up into the side headlock by Mr. Perfect. Here comes Perfect into the ropes. Good shoulder block. And Perfect getting a full head of steam here. Up and over. And Perfect with a drop kick. He got it kind of low there, Brain, but it still had some impact.
Well, he knocked him down, but Costello was smart enough to take a hike.
Another knife edge chop right on the chest of Brian Costello here.
Perfect probably throws the hardest chops in the WWF.
Well, he or Tatanka certainly would have to rank up there as well.
That's right.
You agreed with me on something. Oh, what a momentous week it is.
Something's wrong.
Wow. Irish whip, and Costello going up top, looks a little slow going up, but he'll go faster coming down. Perfect slams Costello right off the top rope, and the end may be near for the man in the green tights. Good knee.
I'll tell you, it's not the height or the fall that hurts you. It's that sudden stop.
Yeah, right. Next snapper by Mr. Perfect.
That hurts all the way from the back of your neck to the top of your buttocks.
Perfect, I know, is looking forward to a one-on-one confrontation with a 6'10", 300-plus pound Diesel.
Whoa, wait a minute. If Perfect wants to win that battle royal, he could three-peat.
Indeed, he could. Indeed, he could. Very astute point there, Brian.
Do you think the dummy, Mr. Perfect knows that?
Of course he knows it. Uh-oh.
Ooh.
Wow. Field goal.
2 points.
And another one.
Another 2 points.
Dallas Cowboys could have used perfect a few weeks ago. Reversal of the whip, center of the ropes now. Costello lowered his head brain.
So much for the Fighting Irish.
He's going to pay for it here. Under the golden dome, Mr. Perfect wins it.
Under Howard Finkel's bald head.
Ladies and gentlemen, as we said, we are very excited about Monday Night Raw this Monday night. What a night it will be as we go to Lord Alfred Hayes and this special report.
Take it away, Limey.
Hello, everyone. This is Special Report. The breathtaking news coming from Jack Tunney's office this week has the World Wrestling Federation spinning back on its heels in awe and anticipation. Shawn Michaels has been officially relieved of the Intercontinental title. Here is President Tunney's authoritative proclamation. Shawn Michaels has failed to appear for a number of Intercontinental title defenses and has refused to fulfill his contractual obligations. Therefore, the World Wrestling Federation had no alternative but to suspend Mr. Michaels and strip him of the Intercontinental Championship. As a result of these actions, I have declared that this Monday night, a 20-man over-the-top rope battle royal will take place on Monday Night Raw. 20 men will battle it out until only two remain. Those two will meet the following Monday night on Monday Night Raw in single competition to determine the new Intercontinental Champion. Now, with that positive declaration in mind, here is a list of the 20 superstars who will be battling in this unique tour de force. Firstly, we have the two-time former Intercontinental Champion, Mr. Perfect. And then, the 1-2-3 Kid, Adam Bomb, Bam Bam Bigelow, Bastian Booger, former WWF Champion Bob Backlund, Bodyguard Diesel, nearly 8 foot tall Giant Gonzalez, Erwin R. Scheister, Jacques of the Quebecers, former Intercontinental Champion Marty Jannetty, a newcomer to the WWF, the rugged MVP, Owen Hart, Razor Ramon, Pierre of the Quebecers, returning especially for this important battle royal, the model Rick Martel, Superfly Jimmy Snuka, Mabel of Men on a Mission, the Native American Tatanka, and finally, the former two-time WWF champion, the incomparable Macho Man Randy Savage. With this highly talented list of superstars vying for the much-coveted Intercontinental Championship, this battle royal will be a fiercely contested and explosive eruption. It all takes place this Monday night on Monday Night Raw. For the World Wrestling Federation, this has been Special Report.
Who loves you, baby? The furniture store, that's who. Come on in. New in town? No credit? Baby, do we have a deal for you. 3 rooms of furniture, $500 down, and in your home today with guaranteed financing. Why rent and pay forever when you can own? Remember, $500 down, 3 rooms of furniture in your home today, and baby, I guarantee it. If you don't buy your furniture at the furniture store, you paid too much.
KTNV Channel 13 invites you to dine at this fine restaurant. Set in the atmosphere of a French country home, André's French Restaurant offers traditional French cuisine prepared under the supervision of Chef André Rochat. A wine selection of over 800 labels, superlative service, and superb cuisine combine to make dining at André's an unforgettable experience. Reservations are suggested. To receive certificates for free dining at this and other fine restaurants, send a self-addressed stamped envelope to KTNV Channel 13.
Have you heard about the new Bertice Berry Show?
The who?
What kind of berry?
My aunt's name's Bernice. No, Bertice. Bertice Berry.
How do you say it?
Bertice Berry.
What is it?
A talk show.
A talk show?
That means y'all are going to talk?
I like that.
They're talking about the new show that will have everyone talking.
What was his name again?
The Bertice Berry Show. Mornings just got interesting.
Bertice, mornings at 11 on Channel 13.
When my grandbaby's older, I'll have to tell him about the hate that used to fill my heart and about Sally, who changed our lives forever. I knew Sally would listen, but I didn't expect to find a new understanding inside myself.
Because of the show, my family and I have quit the Ku Klux Klan.
Today, when I look at our family, I see love. We wouldn't have found that love without Sally.
When the story's this important, it simply has to be Sally.
Sally, weekdays at 3, only on Channel 13.
Hey, welcome back, everyone. Thanks for being with us here on WWF Wrestling Challenge. What an awesome combination the Head Shrinkers are. And there is their inspirational leader, Alpha.
They would scare Tarzan out of the jungle.
Virgil and Red Tyler, the opponents here this week. And Mike McGurk, you best beware of Alpha.
Notice this. Alpha's hair is prettier than McGurk's.
Something, Brain. This Battle Royal Monday night is really going to be something. There are some huge, huge individuals in that over-the-top rope Battle Royal.
Well, I was just, with my computer here, I was just figuring out something. The Giant Gonzalez, Bam Bam Bigelow, Booger, Bastion Booger, and Mabel from Men on a Mission. All just four of those men weigh well over 1,600 pounds. Those four men are well over 400 pounds apiece. That's just four men in that battle royal.
It's really going to be something, plus great rivals like Diesel and Mr. Perfect. Brett the Hitman Hart in the thing. Doink the Clown, the undefeated Atom Bomb, the undefeated Tatanka, the tag team champions. The Quebecers are in it. What an event. And what about Macho Man Randy Savage? He's going to be in it as well.
IRS and Razor Ramon.
Wow.
Look at the size of these Head Shrinkers. Look at the size of Alpha and the Head Shrinkers. I wouldn't want to wrestle them.
Got to be impressed with him. Hey, Virgil, don't turn your back. Virgil turned his back on Batu, and that could be a fatal mistake here in the early going. Powerful headbutt by Batu, and down goes Virgil.
First day you're in this sport, you get your handbook, and you look at it, and it says, do not turn your back. There's only one page. That's all you need to know. Virgil flunked.
Virgil firing up with those right hands. I don't know how much effect they're having, quite honestly. And that chop certainly had an effect. Coming off the second rope on Samu. Oh, this is not going to work.
They'll enjoy this.
Double thrust by the Head Shrinkers. And Virgil, he may be lucky enough, yes he is, to make the tag to Red Tyler.
Everybody knows what a hard head Virgil has. He's used that headbutt for a finish before, hasn't he?
I think he has on occasion.
And the Head Shrinkers knock him down with their headbutts.
Oh, nice move there by Red Tyler. Double clothesline. And Tyler, they got a chance here. A little high-risk offense by the redhead.
He's going to get hurt.
Oh, he got caught. They caught him in midair. Here comes Virgil. Great move by Virgil. Tyler on top.
They got some teamwork, this team of Tyler and Virgil.
Oh, gosh. Virgil almost beheaded at the feet of the Head Shrinkers.
Well, it's not a big loss.
Man, I'll tell you, there's a lot of big tag team matchups in the next few weeks here in the World Wrestling Federation.
I believe the Smoking Guns are watching this match. They better be.
Samu opening up on Tyler out here. Virgil may be unconscious. Referee standing over Virgil. Wow, my goodness.
No, when Virgil's unconscious, he's usually on his feet talking to you.
Well, this is a little strange. What's going on here?
He's hurt.
That double kick by the Head Shrinkers has apparently knocked out Virgil.
He won't wake up till Easter.
And that's going to leave Tyler in there with the Head Shrinkers. I was about to say, so many big tag team matchups coming up in the next few weeks here in the WWF as everybody's trying to get in the title picture. And I got to think, as I said earlier, Brain, when and if the Steiners beat the Quebecers, I really believe the Steiners will regain the WWF Tag Team Championship.
But will they beat Quebec Province Rules?
I don't think so.
I don't either. So what the Quebecers have to do...
Look at Virgil on the right side of our screen.
He's still out.
Virgil is in making a little snooze to Never Never Land.
Look at his chest. He's having a little trouble breathing there.
Yeah. This is not a good situation at all.
No.
We have seen the Head Shrinkers
incapacitate their opponents in the past on many occasions, quite honestly.
Look at Virgil. His hands aren't moving. He's out. He's colder than a mother-in-law's kiss.
Look at Fatu choking Tyler with that tag team rope. And Tyler's already red-faced, getting a bright crimson now.
See, what a lot of people don't understand about the head shrinkers. Money they don't care about. They would just like to get the titles and go back to the island as... Oh my goodness.
Right across the top ring rope.
They'd love to go back as national heroes, which they are anyway. But with the WWF title, that would really mean something. So they don't really care about the money aspect of it. So that's why you got to watch them. They'll get disqualified in an instant. They don't care. They will hurt you really, really bad.
Well, more double team. Tyler driven face first, viciously into the canvas. And you got to think now, Brain, that the end is near.
Is Virgil hurt or is he Goldbricking?
Oh, he's hurt. Of course he's hurt. Look at this, 300 pounds. Right in the abdomen. The air rushing out of the chest of Red Tyler. It's over, fans.
Look at the face on Red Tyler. He's not the same guy. At the end of the match, and he was at the beginning of the match.
So as we said, the head shrinkers with some important tag team matchups coming up in the next few weeks. Against the Smoking Guns, against the Steiner Brothers. They won in the title picture, no doubt about it. Tyler bleeding from the mouth. His lips, he may pop some teeth here.
No, I think it's internal.
Oh,
that
my.
That big squash off the top rope, that's internal.
This guy's
hurt. He never hit him in the mouth.
Virgil knocked unconscious. Red Tyler with some obvious physical problems. Man, they've done it again. This is a brutal team as we go face to face.
Where's the Undertaker when you need him?
Hi, everybody. It's an exciting match we've got going on, and I might add a very busy day here at the WWF, not only on the TV side, but the radio side. Oh, you didn't know? You haven't heard? There is a radio side, Radio WWF. It's on the air Saturday nights, 9 to 11 o'clock Eastern time with Jim Ross and a host of our superstars. But I was talking about busy. A lot of callers, especially from the Midwest, disappointed, perturbed, concerned about the Steiner brothers losing their tag team title to the Quebecers. Well, we have the Quebecers with us right now with their manager, Johnny Polo. I might add that some people are astounded that this happened.
You guys want the scoop? We'll give you the scoop. You ready, guys?
Yes.
We're not the Mounties. We're handsome.
We're brave.
And they're strong. Let me tell you something. I searched the world over, and I found the most phenomenal tag team in the sport of wrestling, and that is why. Yes, that's why they're the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions. Those little Steiner brothers, they're a bunch of crybabies. They're crying. They cheated. They didn't win fair and square. Well, we did win fair and square, and we'll do it again. Tell them, Pierre.
Hey, les Steiners. Vous avez peut-être été à l'Université du Michigan, mais quand on s'est rencontrés dans l'arène, ça paraissait pas pantoute. Vive le Québec! Bien que la page a dit! You bunch of crybaby Americans! You didn't like the World Series! You didn't like the Stanley Cup and hockey! And you ain't gonna like what's coming up with us for the next 2 years to come, boys!
Le Québec, c'est le Québec!
There is another issue in the WWF that has really reached somewhat of a dirty and ugly level, and it might be because a dirty and ugly job was offered to one Razor Ramon. Let's bring Razor in right now on Face to Face. Razor, Irwin R. Shyster, IRS, offered you what he called a domestic job. I think he glorified it. What we were talking about here was toilet cleaning.
You know, Joe, the tax man, he talk about working with your hands, hard work, like there's something bad. I know a lot of people out there work hard every day. The bad guy, he done a lot of work with his hands. I done some bad things with my hands. And tax man, when you step into the ring and look across and see Razor Ramon standing there, Chico, I'm going to do some work with these hands. I'm going to use these hands, Chico, to carve you up.
That is a match a lot of people want to see, right here on the WWF.
Somewhere in Las Vegas, another innocent car owner is being shortchanged.
Definitely a job for GI Man.
GI Man from Desert Inn Motors, on his way to save Las Vegas with cash for your car, paid for or not. GI Man can help you raise tons of cash.
Instant cash for you.
Let us lift your car's trade-in value.
So if you're looking for more cash for your vehicle, come see us at Desert Inn Motors.
GI Man.
On Desert Inn Road, just west of Boulder Highway, we're Desert Inn Motors, the friendly place.
They call him the Bulldog, and Oral Hershiser has always given Dodger fans everything he has and opponents all they wanted. Oral had a year in 1988 that most pitchers dream about. He won the Cy Young Award and broke Don Drysdale's record for shutout innings on the way to a World Series title. In a city full of stars, he shines brightest at Chavez Ravine. Now, Dodger fans can own this official National League Baseball signed by one of the greatest pitchers ever to wear Dodger blue. It comes in this decorative box and pouch, and Hershiser's signature splits the seam. Also available is this blow-up of the Bulldogs' 1992 Upper Deck trading card. It measures 8.5 by 11 and is encased in Lucite. Both of these great products bear a numbered hologram, and that's your guarantee of authenticity. Upper Deck Authenticated is proud to offer Oral's autograph ball for just $59.95 and the card blow-up for only $39.95. They're great gifts and a great way for a new collector to get started. Call 1-800-33-SPORT.
The famous, the cute, the lovable Bert and Ernie from Sesame Street Live will be appearing at Channel 10 Sunday, October the 10th, when the friends of Channel 10, KLVX, and Sunny 106.5 FM present the 7th annual Ice Cream Sunday and Carnival, featuring the exciting Susie Q rides. Come one, come all, step right up for all the ice cream you can eat and entertainment you can't beat.
Same favorites, different times. Tuesday through Friday on Channel 13.
Yeah, Air Force One, you're clear for takeoff. What's the holdup?
Tower, we're going to be delayed on the runway here for about an hour.
Oh, no, not another haircut.
Negative, Tower. The President's expecting an important broadcast. Please keep line USA 9P clear.
Hey, guys, punch up that line. Let's see what the President is watching.
We are live!
Came up, there was one guy left. I forget who it was. I waffled him from behind, and I won it. This 1-2-3 kid is quick, and as lucky as this punk is, he could come out the winner. It's not always the biggest man that wins it.
That sounds like your strategy, but
it worked.
If it worked, it works.
It worked.
1-2-3 kid, side headlock on the veteran Tom Stone here.
Picked up 50 G's just like that.
I'm sure you paid your taxes on that, didn't you?
Of course,
the statutes of limitations have expired. That was probably when, late 50s, early 60s, Brain?
I don't know how cold it was outside.
Side headlock again, but not for long there. Stone missed the clothesline. Look at the quickness of the 1-2-3 kid. Can he survive? Oh, my. He will be the smallest man. We talked about the big man. Good snap. A leg drop right to the face. Look at that. Suddenness of the 1-2-3 kid.
What explosive energy he has.
Look at this. All his martial arts moves. Good move there by the 1-2-3 kid. Snap bears Tom Stone over.
See, but in a battle royal, he's not going to be able to use all that offensive movements he does. He can't drop a leg on a man. He can't kick a man like that.
Well, not in the beginning.
No.
But after it starts getting pared down. Oh, nice move by Tom Stone in the backbreaker. And that slows things down quite considerably here.
But especially, you know, there have been prize money for this and that for battle royals. But this, a shot at becoming the Intercontinental Champion where you can pick. Oh, my goodness.
That hurt my back just watching.
Oh, I love to see that.
Well, you're a little.
I love to see a little punk kid in misery.
He could hide behind Bastion Booger's thigh in this thing. on Monday night. Can you imagine how much reinforcing they're going to have to do to the ring just to hold up that beef?
Boy, I wouldn't want to be in there. You know, think about it. When I was in that battle royal, probably the biggest guy in there was maybe.
Oh, lateral press. He may get it. He almost got it. Excuse me, Bray.
That's okay. The biggest guy in there may have been 300 pounds. Look at this. You got four guys over 400. Well over 400.
Nice sunset flip by the 1-2-3 kid. And he got it. No, he didn't. I thought he had it. 1-2-3 kid came very, very close to getting a pinfall victory here. I had him on guest on a radio program on Radio WWF, of course, every Saturday night, 9 o'clock Eastern time. And the only downside about the program is about what you're going to say here.
My good buddy, Johnny Polo, is the host.
He's the co-host.
Told me he was the host.
Well, he's lying.
Uh-oh.
Snap suplex over, floats over, lateral press. Every time I think about him, I lose my concentration.
He has an effect on a lot of people.
Oh, no kidding. Managing the WWF Tag Champions. And there's a lot of greed involved. There, Shock and Pierre are both in the big ball game. In the big battle royal. What a spinning martial arts kick by the 1-2-3 kid.
See, in this battle royal, it's every man for himself.
And those are some explosive maneuvers. And the youngster will take a chance.
This is too dangerous.
The 19-year-old 1-2-3 kid up, and the moonsault. He hooks the leg coming down. What a move, and what a victory for the 1-2-3 kid.
He could win it. Boy, this is going to be something. I can't wait to see this.
Ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to remind you that the latest edition of Superstar Magazine is available this Tuesday on newsstands nationwide. All the top superstars are profiled. You can't miss it. The Undertaker is on the cover. That's Superstar Magazine, available this Tuesday as we go to the King's Court. His guest, Ludwig Borga.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Jerry the King.
Bret Hart is itching to get his hands on Jerry Burger King Lawler. Makes his way to the King's Court, and this should be most interesting. You know, Lawler's an American, you know.
Of course he is.
Well, I want to welcome everybody to a very special edition of the King's Court.
They'll probably kiss up to Borga.
You know what? I'm going to introduce a gentleman who you people have a little problem accepting, but that's to be expected because you people seem to have a problem with reality. You have a problem. You even have a problem accepting the fact that you all are ruled by a king. Well, this next gentleman tells it like it is. And I think that's why you have a problem with him. He knows you peons for what you really are. He knows this country for what it really is. And he's undefeated since coming to the World Wrestling Federation. That's the reality of the situation. Now let's make him feel welcome. Let's show some respect. Here he is, all the way from Helsinki, Mr. Ludwig Borga.
Be interesting to see how he treats Jerry Lawler.
Well, Lawler's gonna need chapstick before this one's over with. All that kissing up he's gonna do. Can't wait.
Borga. Lawler's not that kind of man.
Yeah, he is. Borga and Lex Luger. I want to see that.
I never kiss up to him.
Mr. Borga, I must apologize. Here they're playing the Finland national anthem, and these peons don't have enough respect to even stand up.
Eihän nää kusit vaan ymmärrä mitään perkele, mitä täytyy tehdä.
You know, tell us again, I'm sorry. Please. You must understand, these idiots only speak one language. If you would, I, of course, can understand you. But while you're out here, would you mind speaking in English?
Give me a break.
Yes, of course, I forgot. You morons don't speak only but one language. What I said was, you people have no respect for your superiors. But I don't have any respect for Lex Luger either. And I don't have any respect for his friends. And I don't have any respect for his family. And I for sure don't have any respect for this stinking country.
Now, Mr. Borga.
Gosh, I can't believe Lex Luger, that man.
He drove that broken down old bus all across this country, the Lex Express. And he showed everybody the fruited plains. And he showed them the purple mountains' majesty. But you know this country for what it really is. You tell it like it really is. And tell him what you're going to do to Lex Luger when you get him in the ring.
Lex Luger says he stands for this country. He is like the rivers that runs through this nation, polluted. And Lex Luger stands for the schools of this country. Well, Mr. King, did you know that this country is the only country in the world that you can graduate from high school without reading and writing? Yes, and I'm gonna tear Lex Luger apart the same way this country is crumbling, piece by piece, because its lazy workers don't do anything.
But Mr. Borga, Lex Luger says that he is the backbone of America.
Well, if Lex Luger is the backbone of this stinking country, I, Ludwig Borga, will break it.
Stand up! Stand up for a true champion! Ludwig Borga!
Man, I despise that man. He's gonna pay when he meets Luger.
20 years ago, four men took their positions in the Los Angeles Dodger infield after eight seasons. Steve Garvey, Davey Lopes, Bill Russell, and Ron Say had collected four National League pennants. Owners of this Dodger commemorative sheet will always have a reminder of that time in Dodger history. Hand-signed by all four men, it comes in a beautiful leather folder. Use your credit card to order this great gift idea for $59.95. Call toll-free 1-800-33-SPORT.
Don't you get tired of these supermarket tablets? I mean, look at this. Elvis seen shopping at Las Vegas Manufacturing Jewelers. Look, I haven't seen the king. Not that we couldn't offer him an exceptional value on a diamond belt buckle. He couldn't find a better price than at Las Vegas Manufacturing Jewelers. And now with three locations, we're easy to get to, no matter where he lives.
Excuse me, ma'am. How much is that belt buckle up there?
Las Vegas Manufacturing Jewelers. Never pay high retail prices again.
They're the most relentless news team on television.
And I'm a pig farmer named Ed.
They're dedicated to truth, justice, and fashion.
I caught him sniffing my shoes.
But more than anything, they're out to get laughs. See, I can be fun too. They're the Murphy Brown team.
I am bad.
Be sure they're not investigating you. Just watch them every chance you get.
My life is so much easier this way.
On Murphy Brown.
Practice Murphy's Law, Tuesday through Friday at 7.
Hi, I hear you're a book lover.
Right, and a proud friend.
We're friends of the Southern Nevada Libraries. Ah, friend, is this a good time?
Right again. Time for the Friends Annual Used Book Sale, October 30th and 31st.
At the Las Vegas Library, across from Cashman Field.
Right, I'm writing.
Write 382-3493 for free donation pickup.
All you lovers, friends, and neighbors, donate now.
And don't miss the October 30th and 31st
Annual Used Book Sale.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. The latest release from Coliseum Home Video, entitled Grudges, Gripes, and Grunts, will be available this Wednesday. And Brain is really going to be something.
And it's hosted by Randy Macho Man Savage, and you'll be able to see Bam Bam Bigelow and the lovely Luna Vachon on their yacht.
Plus, a wrestling lesson from the Steiner Brothers. It's Grudges, Gripes, and Grunts from Coliseum Home Video, available this Wednesday.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
Icapro, you've got to want it.
Cobra's building an ultimate
weapon, but standing in the way, G.I. Joe!
It's good versus evil, and this time the battle's bigger than ever!
G.I. Joe figures and vehicles sold separately.
Man your battle station.
Man your battle station.
It's electronic talking battleship, so real it really talks.
Battleship sunk.
Yay!
Electronic talking battleship only from Milton Bradley.
Well, there you see it, ladies and gentlemen. Not only is Johnny Polo, you probably need that,
led to the ring,
the manager of that awesome individual, Adam Bomb. He is also now, as we know, the manager of the new WWF Tag Team Champions, the Quebecers.
Is that the Adam Bomb exploding or Vince Coleman driving by?
Boy, what destruction this Adam Bomb has perpetrated on his opponents. The youngsters looking on with awe.
And he makes his...
I find it most challenging to have to spend my Saturday evenings on Radio WWF with Johnny Polo. That's for darn sure.
Hey, there's Conan O'Brien from Late Night.
No, it's not.
No, you're right. That kid's a lot brighter looking.
There you see the erstwhile Master Polo.
Just think how he's taken the WWF by storm. He's got this huge, huge man here, Adam Bomb. He's now the manager of the WWF Tag Team Champions, and he hosts Radio WWF.
Yeah, he's played quite an impact, no doubt about it.
Don't take a picture of me.
Well, this phenomenal athlete, ladies and gentlemen, will be arriving in Israel on Thursday when the WWF starts another international tour.
Destruction!
And, of course, this tour will continue not only through Israel, but such beautiful cities as Vienna, Austria, Lisbon, Portugal, and then on to Germany. Great fans will see the biggest stars in the World Wrestling Federation beginning this Thursday, October 7th.
We'll never see anything like it.
Adam Bomb. As we have mentioned, 6'7", or maybe 6'8", just around the 300-pound mark.
Bowl of cherries, and that guy's in the pits.
Boy, he's a real smart mouth, is that Polo?
I like him.
I'm sure you would. He was another silver spooner, just like you. But this Adam Bomb is an amazing athlete. He can maul you.
Life, liberty, and the pursuit of pain.
But you want to slap him when he does that little smart
No,
laugh.
No.
You like, you really
makes
like,
sense.
Somebody told me the other day, I think it was Arnold Skolin, said that Polo reminded him of a young Bobby Heenan.
You were talking to Arnold Skolin?
Of course I was.
Why?
Look at that move right there. From the vertical suplex.
I didn't know you could still have a conversation with a man over 200 years old.
Adam Bomb. Arnie's a great guy. Adam Bomb just is destroying Todd Becker here.
This Adam Bomb is going to hurt somebody.
Look at how red Becker's ribs, the side is right there. You can see that right where he came down on the top ring rope. Now, that's a steel cable inside that casing there.
It won't be long. He'll be glowing soon.
Modified belly-to-back suplex by this big man. I know that Polo's got Adam Bomb signed up for some tag team matches in the next few weeks. They're going to be something. This is an awesome, awesome man. Uh-oh. The end is near. Here comes the Adam Smasher, no doubt about it. Adam Bomb, he's undefeated. He's on his way to Monday Night Raw and a big battle royal brain.
I'll tell you something, when that mushroom cloud clears and all the debris is left laying, that man could be standing there, the next WWF Intercontinental Champion and the winner of the Battle Royal.
Fans, when we come back, we'll show you something very special involving Yokozuna and The Undertaker.
Your world, your country, it matters. Peter Jennings, America's most watched anchor. Your state, your town. It matters. John Daly and Allison McCarthy. Inside Las Vegas. News matters. And it matters where you get your news. Weeknights at 5, News 13, Inside Las Vegas. World News Tonight with Peter Jennings at 5:30. It matters.
When my grandbaby's older, I'll have to tell him about the hate that used to fill my heart and about Sally, who changed our lives forever. I knew Sally would listen, but I didn't expect to find a new understanding inside myself.
Because of the show, my family and I have quit the Ku Klux Klan.
Today, when I look at our family, I see love. We wouldn't have found that love without Sally.
When the story's this important, it simply has to be Sally.
Sally, weekdays at 3, only on Channel 13.
Stop. Right there. Go back. Why is it that we can look right past an image like this, of a child in desperate need, and not be moved to outrage, to action? Can we watch a fly-covered infant, too weak to move, and not be moved to do something? How can you and I not be sickened by the fact that this child may have counted days between meals, not just hours? Tragically, these precious children don't have the power to change their world. But you do. All it takes is calling Save the Children and saying yes to sponsorship. Far from a handout, your $20 monthly gift will be combined with those of other sponsors to bring lasting benefits to an entire village. You'll help children and their families learn to help themselves. Please, pick up your phone now and sponsor a helpless child who's waiting and hoping.
Ladies and gentlemen, before we go back to the ring, we'd like to take you back to WWF Superstars, an interview conducted by our colleague Bonnie Blackstone with the WWF champion Yokozuna, his official spokesman Jim Cornette, and of course Mr. Fuji, when a very ominous stranger made a surprise appearance.
Well, there's only one ominous stranger, and he's not a stranger. We're talking about The Undertaker, him and his grave robbing buddy, Paul Bearer.
This was a very tense situation. Let's take a look.
Get my chair.
Nobody, nowhere, no how, not on this planet, not till a spaceship lands. Nobody.
Wait a minute. What's going on here? What is that at the light? We've had technical difficulties.
Can't Jack Tunney pay the light bill? What's happening here?
Who's my wallet?
In the world?
We can hear.
What the heck is going on?
We can hear some commentary, but we don't.
I'm out of here.
Look at that!
Whoa.
Look at that! Look at that!
Check this out!
Look at that!
I love that. My challenge is this: bring that belt and your soul and meet me in the dark side.
This tank.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, that is going to be something.
One fall.
When The Undertaker meets Yokozuna one-on-one for the WWF title. If you have the opportunity, whatever you do, don't miss that one.
Kevin Kruger.
You know, as much as I get along with James E. Cornette and Mr. Fuji. Wait a minute.
What's Harvey doing to these guys? Harv in that great black suit. Timothy Well and Stephen Dundry. What's going on here, Brain? Did you know about this?
Well, I've heard rumor through my grapevine, through the brain vine, that Harvey Whippleman was going to be managing a new team. And this is it. Well done. And it's a heck of a team. And the ladies love these two. Now they're going to love three of them.
Yeah, Harvey's had a bonded reputation as quite a ladies' man. Look at the little weasel. No offense. Present company excluded, of course.
Of course.
A little rat.
Harvey is a home wrecker, though.
Look at him. Right. It looks seedy to me. You know, I was looking on Jack Tunney's desk. I mean, I was looking at a memo, a press release the other day. She must like Well Done. And he had a memo that had Well Done soon to meet Men on a Mission. And that's a pretty important matchup as far as the tag team rankings are concerned.
Well, very, if that's true. Now, you were sneaking and you broke into his office?
No, I had a meeting.
You pulled a Watergate on Jack Tunney, right?
No, absolutely not.
You broke in, bugged the office, and tried to get yourself on the cover of the new magazine coming out. I know it.
That's the only way I would be in a magazine is to be caught shoplifting or... No, never mind.
Well, if you got rid of that Tex Ritter outfit you wear with that 3-gallon hat and those lousy-looking manure boots, maybe somebody would put you in a magazine.
Oh, man, I tell you, Kevin Kruger, good-looking athlete, arm drag takeover on, is that Stephen Dunn? Of course it is.
Yes.
Of course, his partner's Timothy Well. This is a quick team, very offensive-minded team. Hey, Kevin, he's over there. Oh, clothesline.
That was a setup, and the ham and egger fell for it.
He did indeed. Hook, line, and sinker.
Well, I can't wait to see that match with The Undertaker and Yoko.
Good drop kick. Yeah, that's going to be something. I admire the WWF promoters and all the WWF officials for signing that matchup. That is, I mean, everybody would want to see that.
What is going on with Randy Macho Man Savage and Crush?
Hey, that's another interesting situation, isn't it?
I'm not sure I know what's really going on there. Seems to me like Crush is ignoring him.
Crush seems to be willing to talk to you, willing to talk to Vince McMahon, but every time he hears Macho Man's voice, seems like he hangs up.
Well, that'd be my first move.
Well, I heard that Crush said he was never going to speak to Savage again. That's pretty extreme because they were best of friends, you know.
Well, Savage is the one that saved him from being totally smeared by Yokozuna on Monday Night Raw. Savage pulled him out of the ring. Savage, I think, even went to the hospital with him.
That teamwork by Well Done. And they have dominated this tag team event with a variety of very cohesive offensive maneuvers. And now they can't decide on who's going to take the pin here. How about the legal man there, ref? That might be a good idea. How about the legal guy? Referee Danny Davis does even know the legal guy. It really doesn't make any difference. Well Done has been dominant here.
I like those trunks.
Well Done, and their new manager, Harvey Whippleman, victorious here in the WWF. Before we go to the break, ladies and gentlemen, let us take you now to some footage of the latest film of Hulk Hogan. It's titled Mr. Nanny. It premieres this coming Friday here in the USA.
Take out the papers and the trash.
They don't need a babysitter.
I can handle myself.
And they don't need a personal trainer.
I hate kids.
What these brats need is a hand that socks the cradle. Hulk Hogan.
He's one tough mother.
Is Mr. Nanny.
Lovely to see you.
You have to kiss Dolly.
Don't tell anybody I did that.
Yeah! Ha! Mr. Nanny!
Mr. Nanny.
And get that pinky up.
Hey, baby, who loves you? The furniture store, that's who. Come on in. We have easy financing for everyone. We offer no down payment, instant credit, 90 days same as cash, and no payments till next year. In addition, we're talking top name brands on sale every day. We offer special discounts to military, casino workers, and cash buyers. Remember, low prices, easy financing, and fast delivery. If you don't buy your furniture at the furniture store, you paid too much.
They call him the Bulldog, and Oral Hershiser has always given Dodger fans everything he has and opponents all they wanted. Oral had a year in 1988 that most pitchers dream about. He won the Cy Young Award and broke Don Drysdale's record for shutout innings on the way to a World Series title. In a city full of stars, he shines brightest at Chavez Ravine. Now, Dodger fans can own this official National League Baseball signed by one of the greatest pitchers ever to wear Dodger blue. It comes in this decorative box and pouch, and Hershiser's signature splits the seam. Also available is this blow-up of the Bulldog's 1992 Upper Deck trading card. It measures 8.5 by 11 and is encased in Lucite. Both of these great products bear a numbered hologram, and that's your guarantee of authenticity. Upper Deck Authenticated is proud to offer Oral's autograph ball for just $59.95 and the card blow-up for only $39.95. They're great gifts and a great way for a new collector to get started. Call 1-800-33-SPORT.
Oprah, weekdays at 4, only on Channel 13.
Welcome back, everyone. Here is the bad guy. Brain, this guy is something, isn't he?
He is the bad guy.
Walking to the ring with a great deal of confidence, oozing machismo.
There's Mr. T starter kit around his neck.
Capacity crowd, they love this guy.
He can't be trusted, Ross. He's turned his back on all of us.
What do you mean, all of us? Who, you got a problem in your pocket?
Well, I'm talking about the likes of myself and Johnny Polo and
IRS.
Yeah, the decent people in the WWF.
Well, you know anything about this opponent that Razor Ramon's going to go one-on-one with here, Brain? Rock Werner.
Rock Werner? Are you sure isn't Rock Rogowski?
No, it's Rock. Maybe his middle name may be Rogowski. I don't have any idea. As let's listen to this. There'll be some instructions here.
You know him right now, Chico.
Okay. I didn't know that kid's name was Chico. I see him around here all the time. Razor Ramon, ladies and gentlemen. Hey, this guy is really on a roll. 6'7", 287. And since his resounding victory over Ted DiBiase at SummerSlam. Ooh, that hurts.
What great shape he's in.
This guy has been undaunted, and he will be in the big 20-man battle royal this Monday night on Raw. And he's going to be, as the old cliche goes, Brain, a force to be reckoned with.
You know who I think has the best chance of anyone to win it? Would be the Quebecers, because they will work as a team.
Oh, man.
Just broke him in half.
Rock was crushed into pebbles there.
That's it, he says.
We may be about to see the razor's edge. You know, the traditional finishing maneuvers, they don't count in this battle royal.
They certainly don't.
It's over the top rope to the floor Monday night on Raw. Boy, he drove him into the, right into the canvas. This one is academic, ladies and gentlemen. Razor Ramon, will he be able to survive the 20-man over-the-top rope battle royal this Monday night on Raw? Here's face-to-face.
I'm going now.
Back to more wrestling action in just a moment, folks, but welcome back to Face to Face. And as we mentioned earlier in the show, you've been enjoying it on TV, but if you want to enjoy World Wrestling Federation on the radio, it's now possible. Radio WWF is on the air Saturday nights, 9 to 11 Eastern time, with Jim Ross and a host of our World Wrestling Federation superstars. You have a chance to call in by calling 1-800-WWF-8686. If you don't have Radio WWF in your city, it's a simple call to your radio station. If it's a news station, an all-sports station, tell them, get with it. Come on, get with the times. Bring in Radio WWF at your radio station. And those that do have Radio WWF, we've been getting a lot of calls. Who's next for the World Wrestling Federation champion, Yokozuna? Well, I'll tell you who is next. It's The Undertaker. We have both of our principals and their entourage right now. The champion, Yokozuna, with their manager, Mr. Fuji, and Jim Cornette. And, of course, in the darkness, The Undertaker, I see Paul Bearer and The Urn have returned. This is going to be a major battle. Mr. Cornette, it's a fact, though. The Undertaker is unaffected by pain.
Let me just say this. It's a fact that The Undertaker has been unaffected by anybody else's pain they've dished out, but not the pain dished out by Yokozuna. Paul Bearer's been hiding somewhere for all these past months. Maybe he was the new centerfold in Famous Monsters of Filmland. Yeah, I see you, you pasty-faced little weasel. Let me tell you something, Gomez Adams. You bring that ashtray. You bring it to ringside. You're not going to have any effect on my man Yokozuna. Mr. Fuji will be there to keep an eye on you. And as for The Undertaker, those brittle bones that have been rotting ever since you passed away, whoever knows how long ago, can still be broken just like anybody else's. And the pain that you can feel down deep inside can only be brought out by the bonsai drop of the great Yokozuna. So when you get in there and you attempt a challenge for this man's gold belt, you just remember one thing, Undertaker. I don't know whether you're human down deep, but I guarantee you, Yokozuna can make you feel some human emotions and some human pain. You say you don't feel pain? Well, this man doesn't feel fear. So you try to scare him, he'll try to hurt you.
Oh, what a fatal mistake Yokozuna has made.
having Jim Cornette and Mr. Fuji handle his affairs. What they've actually done is signed his death warrant. In Japan, they use cremation to bury the dead. Oh, what a bonfire Yokozuna will make. And that death will be all ours.
Yokozuna, it's time that you realize I'm the most powerful entity in the World Wrestling Federation. I'll take that belt, but more important, I'll take your soul. Rest in peace.
Here's a consumer warning from Auto Insurance America. Drinking and driving is a deadly combination. If you get a DUI, you'll pay a large fine, your driver's license suspended, you may wind up in jail. You'll have a hassle you just don't need. But if you've made a mistake, Auto Insurance America can help you get back on the road with immediate proof of insurance, reasonable rates, and convenient payment plans. We'll solve your insurance problems.
Have an auto insurance problem? Stop spinning your wheels!
Come see me, your uncle, at Auto Insurance America. Look for me in the Yellow Pages.
Danny, when are these headlines going to come to an end?
Las Vegas manufacturing jeweler sells wedding bands to aliens? I must admit, the best prices in the known universe on jewelry are here at Las Vegas manufacturing jewelers. But wedding bands to aliens?
Sir, I think your wife would like this.
Oh, thank you.
For extraterrestrial, that's extra special values, shop Las Vegas manufacturing jewelers.
Las Vegas manufacturing jewelers never pay high retail prices again.
Your world, your country, it matters. Peter Jennings, America's most watched anchor. Your state, your town, it matters. John Daly and Allison McCarthy, Inside Las Vegas. News matters, and it matters where you get your news. Weeknights at 5, News 13, Inside Las Vegas. World News Tonight with Peter Jennings at 5:30. It matters.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
New WWF figures. Give you the power of Hulkamania, the knockoff Prince of Virgil, the audacity of IRS, and the madness of the Macho Man. Collect new WWF figures now. Sold separately. Dig it.
Bring the excitement of arcade basketball home with Electronic Hot Shot Basketball. There's a motorized moving backboard, electronic game sounds, and digital scoreboard. Milton Bradley Electronic Hot Shot Basketball.
Mark's Nightmare, now on Genesis, with Bartzilla, Itchy and Scratchy, Homer Kong, Markman, and more. Mark's Nightmare, now on Super NES and Genesis, from Acclaim.
Joining us next week on Wrestling Challenge will be those two punk barnyard buffoons, the Smoking Guns.
Plus, ladies and gentlemen, Irwin R. Scheister will be here.
And joining us will be the great Native American Indian star, undefeated Tatanka.
Plus, that fat pig, Bastion Booger.
And the punk of all punks, except the 1-2-3 Kid, former Intercontinental Champion, Marty Jannetty.
And the man who hates America, Ludwig Borga.
And on the King's Court with Jerry the King Lawler will be Mr. Perfect.
For The Brain, ladies and gentlemen, I'm Jim Ross, saying so long, everybody.
Take a hike.